The fighting spirit. You should never ever fucking back down from a challenge. Any challenger, anything in the form of a problem that shows up in your life, you should be making a decisive decision to fucking maim, to fucking cut, to fucking mutilate, to go through that shit like fucking butter. Because that's what it means to have the fucking fighting spirit. Nowadays, what we have is an epidemic of fucking cowards, of men who can't fight for themselves, men who can't fucking stand up and deal with the problems that's going on in the world, men who just wanna sit behind the computer and fucking jack off all day. You have all these beautiful, wonderful women from all over the world, from wonderful backgrounds, and you wanna go on the internet and you wanna go on Instagram and be busy looking at women there rather than women in real life. Oh my fucking God. You have your whole life fucking ahead of you. And because you simply cannot be a challenger, you don't step forward to the challenge and fucking make a decision to make it clear that you have a specific standard that you live your life with. But thank you so much for being a cunt, because you make it easy for men like me to come and grab the fucking prize. And there's so many fucking prizes in the skies. For men like me, it just becomes fucking easy. But I'm fucking tired of there not being any fucking competition out there. I'm fucking tired of there not being any men that I can fucking look into the eyes of as fucking equals. Because guess what? I don't want to look at you like you're some fucking shit below me. But since you make the decisions that you make, I have no choice but to look at you like you're fucking not shit. Don't you fucking understand that you have picked a lower standard for your life? Don't you understand that you can be stronger, you can be smarter, you can be much more agile, you can be fucking Hercules in the fucking building? But you chose a fucking bitch, weak, cunt, retarded of a standard for your life. And on top of that, you want to fucking settle and not have a fighting spirit. Because any real man like me can look you in the fucking eyes. I can see that you don't mean what you mean. You're not willing to die for the shit that you want in your fucking life. You say that you want that girl, but you just, you know, your emotions got you. You say you don't want to make that fucking YouTube video. You say you don't want to start that page. You say you don't want to fucking go to that restaurant and try that meal. You say you don't want to go travel down that place. What has gotten you so afraid of life that you're shriveling and you're thinking of cutting off your balls and becoming a transgender woman, metaphorically speaking, and not deal with the challenges ahead? Instead, you want to settle for what's fucking easier. Well, guess what? When you choose fucking easy, with easy comes no fucking growth. There was a plastic surgeon who used to do plastic surgery on women. Now I'm going to give you a little cunts a break, and we're going to talk about women for a second. There was a plastic surgeon who did plastic surgeries on women. And after doing plastic surgeries on women, he found out that even if you change the fucking biological state of the body, and you give that female the big ass boobies, the big ass bedonky donks, and the big ass chichis, you know what he found out? Their psychological state is still fucked up. Meaning, they still speak with that same mind before they even have the fucking plastic surgery. So if you think that a fucking little surgery, if you think that cutting off your fucking dick and giving yourself a little fucking plastic pussy, metaphorically speaking, is gonna fucking save your life and help you and get you attention and get people to care for you and people to coddle you and people to pay attention for you. Now, since there's so many, there's so many bitch-ass niggas in this world, metaphorically speaking. Figuratively speaking, of course. Oh, man. Guess what? You're gonna find another cunt bitch to meet your standards of being a cunt bitch. So you have two people who have absolutely no standards in life, who absolutely have no dignity, metaphorically speaking, who absolutely have no purity of heart, who absolutely have no fighting spirit, who have absolutely have no courage in their hearts to get up and put a fight against the matrix holographic consciousness that the world presents in front of them. Man, this generation is groomed to be a bunch of little weaklings. Man. And they did a good job on the predictive programming. Shout out Garmin, good job. Shout you guys out. I know you Masons are sitting back and laughing at people falling for these traps and these operational variables that you presented them with. But a real man is on the fucking scene now. Because people just simply need an example of what to be, how to be. Since you've never seen an alpha male before, since your dad has settled for survival, since your parents, unfortunately, didn't instill in you such a strong belief about yourself that you don't compare yourself to anyone else and you can comfortably hold your stand with anyone else. Since your parents put that in you, you know what, man? I'm gonna go a little easy on you. Because I know just like me, you was raised with weak parents who don't understand what it takes to take over the world. Because when you're listening to the environment, when you're following social programs that are deliberately inputted by your fucking environment, and they're there on purpose. Look at the top performing people in the world. Look at Muhammad, look at Jesus, look at fucking Moses. I was talking to a fucking 60-year-old and we were having this conversation. For you to even look at Andrew Tate, for you to even fucking take a position like that in life, you must have some fucking balls. You must be able to fucking overcome every single fucking social program in the fucking world around you. And not be absorbed by it. You should program the fucking environment. That's what it means to be a Magi. That's what it means to be a fucking Magus. That's what it means to be a fucking prophet. That's what it means to be a fucking messenger. Is to pick your fucking position in your messianic office, which God has destined you with since you was fucking born. Your fucking birthright. Your fucking seat on the fucking throne. But you just abandoned that shit for some shit of the world. And you actually think that that's the right thing. Gentlemen, ladies, we have a lot of work to do because we have a world that we need to rebuild and regain and put back together. We need to put back the minds of the people together, and this will not be no easy task. I simply need the strongest men. I simply need the strongest women for this task and for you guys to ultimately become figures of authority in your areas of expertise and your subject matter expert. For you to become a subject matter expert in your area of life. Because guess what? You went through some shit, didn't you? Don't you know that your scars eventually become your claws? So what the fuck are you scared of, bruh? You should have been. Now, I don't know what your individual situation is. Some of you guys might be raised at home, sheltered. The moment you trip outside because of a rock, you get mad at your mom and dad because they didn't tell you there were rocks and there were problems outside and they sheltered you. Now, to your benefit, your parents were probably fucking cunts too. They should have told you a little thing or two about the things of the world. I know your school teachers didn't prepare you. I know your school teachers fucked up your mind. They didn't prepare you for shit. I know your mom and dad, they didn't prepare you for shit. You don't even have a single ounce of self-esteem that's been put in you by a fucking real alpha G like myself. That's why I'm here doing this shit, because I take this shit fucking personal, bro. Because after seeing what this world's becoming, after seeing what I was becoming through the social programs and engineering of this world, bruh, you better drop your balls to the fucking floor and you better get ready to take over some shit. Because we're not taking over no physical territory, we're taking over some mental fucking territory. The mental territory comes in the form of your fucking mind, the land which has been taken. God's lands are God's glands. So now you're letting some other fool putting chemicals in your food and turning you into a female with estrogen, metaphorically speaking. And you're just letting that shit happen to you. You're not going to say anything about it. Because you actually like being, you know, the C word. You actually like being the B word. Yeah, you know, it offers you some benefits. You stay safe. Can nobody, you can complain, you can cry. You can call your social worker, your principal, your teacher. But eventually, all those figures of authority that you was hoping and counting on, they're not going to be there all the time. And if you need someone, if you need someone with bigger balls than you to come through and drop their big balls on the table like me to protect you, then sadly, you're in big trouble. So we must start today building up your self-esteem. And we're going to do this with each video. We're going to do this with each product. We're going to do this with each service. We're going to do this with each information that I'm going to be providing. So don't be a cunt. Be a fucking alpha male. If you're a man, be an alpha male. If you're a female, be a feminine, beautiful female. I understand that these men of today are fucked up, ladies. But, hey, there's always some of us out there, so don't be afraid.